Because I wanted to teach kids about LGBTQ+ issues. I also want to help queer kids like me feel a little less alone. My mom found that we brought this big bucket of LGBTQ books. And I thought I'd start my YouTube channel by telling you guys how I feel about them. The first one I'm doing is The Sissy Duckling by Harvey Fierstein, illustrated by Henry Cole. What I'm thinking is those right there are his or hers parents. I don't really know what's going to happen in this book, but I'm guessing it's going to be a lot of fun. Elmer is not like the other boy ducklings. While they like to build forts, he loves to bake cakes. While they like to play baseball, he wants to put on the halftime show. Elmer is a great big sissy. But when his father is wounded by a hunter's shot, Elmer proves that the biggest sissy can also be the greatest hero. It shows here that lots of people like different things. Like his friends want to play baseball or build forts, and that's fine. But what Elmer wants to do is bake cakes and put on the halftime show, and it's all fine because lots of people like different things. I have a question. What's a sissy?
I think it's like a mean name for a duck that's not very stereotypically manly, I guess, in this situation.
And that's... Ready to read this book. This is my little sister Rosie. Today we're going to be reading a book. I'm so excited. I forgot her name. What's his name? I don't know.
Read it.
Elmer.
Elmer.
Elmer was the happiest duckling in the whole forest. Elmer was not so different, but he always did remain special. I like this book because Elmer showed a lot of bravery and was very smart. When he saw the oak tree, he knew he could make it into a house. And when he found his dad, he took care of him. Like, he made him soup, they played together, they still had fun, and his dad got better. And he also showed one person that used to be a big bully that they shouldn't be that mean, and then they became friends. So the dad was fine, and they became friends, and that's why I liked it. It was very nice. I like the part when the sissy comes back and
don't say sissy.
And saved his dad. Rosie, do you know what a sissy is?
No.
It's a rude way of saying that someone is doing the the opposite is everyone else's. So like if in this book it's saying that everyone else is playing baseball and he wants to like put on a halftime show and dance. But what, and he wants to do stuff that other people don't, and that's fine. Oh, but it's rude to say someone is a sissy. It's a mean way of saying it. You can say like, their actual name, or like, he, she, and like other stuff, but sissy's a very mean name. Oh. If someone called me a sissy, I'd feel upset, angry, and sad. But I'd also know that sissy also, it might be mean, but it also means you're special. I would feel sad. Thank you for coming and listening to the story. Now it's time for you to go to bed.
I'm a very super hero princess.
Is that a working title?
Mustache.
Sorry about that. I think she was overtired. These are all the feelings I had when I was reading the book. Sad. I felt sad when Elmer left home and his parents were about to leave for the winter without him. And then the dad got shot. I thought he was gonna like die. Excited to know what happened next in the book. Angry that all the boys were treating him that way. Shy because it was my first video. Hopeful. I hoped that dad wouldn't die. Happy. I was happy I got to read the book. And I was happy that everyone became friends at the end. Thankful. I was thankful that I got to read the book. I felt proud of who I am. The biggest thing I learned in this book was that everyone is special in their own way. That people are different and it's okay. Because one day everyone will surprise someone. Thank you for watching and I hope I see you next time. Goodbye!